Previously on Alan Wake, I wrote a horror story that has come true. Thomas Zane did the same in the 70s.
You will go no further.
If I continue like the Dark Presence wants me to, the story I'm writing won't save Alice. It's a horror story. No one will survive.
You knew Zane! Thomas Zane! You're the Lady of the Light in the song!
He left something behind to help me. The clicker.
Alan thought of this as he stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, the clicker in his hand. He took a deep breath and jumped.
I can get to her now. I can finish this. Was about to explode and the light hurt my eyes. I needed my sunglasses and painkillers to dull the pain.
Ah!
In my finer moments of self-deception, I swore to quit drinking.
So we're in the same shoes that Barry was in earlier. Welcome back to Let's Play Alan Wake again. I'm BurningDogFace. And I assure you, that noise is entirely in-game. I need a jump cut. Just a moment. Okay. Let's see. 2 years ago in New York, Wake regains consciousness after a rough night. And it sounds like it was a rough night. He was facing the wrong way on the bed, fully clothed. I always feel like, oh yeah, it was a bad day if I wake up and my shoes are on. I remember the first hangover I ever had. I woke up fully clothed from the waist down, naked from the waist up, with marker drawn all over my chest in my own handwriting. Including things like, I am a genius, and go see that movie. And later I did find my shirt, which was missing. I had apparently soaked it in water and placed it in the freezer of my fridge in order to ensure that it would completely freeze solid.
Ugh. The sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun.
Fuck me, I can't even see the ground. And the sky isn't much to look at. Yeah, he doesn't seem like somebody's having an amazing day. Nice decor, though. Kind of a small bed for a millionaire, artist. Kind of a small place for a millionaire, I gotta say. So, oh yeah, this is the Max Payne bit. Yes, the one I accidentally gave away. Sorry about that. So let me just, making sure something was working.
The pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again.
I know that feeling, yeah. Huh. Isn't hers sinks? Isn't that cute? The tiniest dryer. Or is that a washing machine? I can't tell.
There was a message waiting for me on the machine.
Is Alice in? By the way, if this is 2 years ago, how come it's still a calendar for 2010? Just saying. Let me see. Can I have that QR code reader? Just to make sure it's the same one. All right. Browse website. And that doesn't work because my phone is in offline mode, you brain genius. Vision 2. Yes, so I've seen this one. Okay, just making sure. I really wish there was a plaque I could read on that gun trophy. It's gotta be like the Hard Boiled Society's award for best noir thriller. Well, it's Alan Wake, so clearly he's going to ignore the message for as long as possible. You know, I never mentioned the joke behind the name, which, to be fair, no one would possibly get outside of my family. Like, obviously I am playing Alan Wake again, but I was referencing something. Alice doesn't seem to be home. I mean, if Alan was drinking that heavily last night, it's possible they're arguing. What the hell is that thing next to the spoon? Not the spatula, the other thing. But yes, there was like an SNES game back in the day. And, I heard two stories, but it's a very odd name. See, it was about, it's this land that was once saved by, three ninja warriors who showed up at their darkest hour. And the prophecy said that when the land faces its darkest hour again, the three ninja warriors will, return and, save it from evil. So, you know, even though you're playing a game that's set in, like, this cyberpunk future, you know, ruled over by the man, you're still playing as cyborg ninjas who show up out of nowhere to overthrow the man and, you know, save the day. And, you know, it was a side-scrolling action game, let's be clear. The entire depth of the story is pretty much what I just told you. But, the reason it stuck in the minds of myself and my brothers is that the name of this game was Ninja Warriors Again. And I've heard of some conflicting explanations over the years. Some of them just say that, well, it's just called that because it's a Japanese game and they make weird use of English sometimes. The ones I like even more, the theory goes that it was actually released in Japan under a name like The Return of the Ninja Warriors, and it just got really badly translated and they made it into English. Ninja Warriors Again. So here we are, playing Alan Wake again. Because sure enough, ever since we learned about that game, my brothers and I have referred to remasters and remakes as Name of Game Again. Like when I got Halo Anniversary for the first time back in 2011, I remember knocking on my brother's door and saying, "Hey, you want to play Halo 1 again?" Alright, let's listen to this message instead of listening to me babble. Why don't you be me on the line just to make this even more meta and surreal than it already is?
You have one new message.
Al! Are you still asleep? Wakey, wakey! You should have your show on your TiVo. If Alice wasn't too mad to record it, as she called me earlier and really chewed me out. Yeah, we went a little overboard last night. But parties are a part of this business. Al, look, I'm saying this as your friend. She's not doing your career any favors by trying to run your life like that, okay? I'll talk to you later, Al. Watch the show!
It really bothers me more than I thought it would that the number pad on that phone is way off center. Also, that makes me uncomfortable.
I'd been a guest on the talk show the previous night, talking about my latest book.
Oh, that would explain the party.
The show was supposed to be waiting for me on our TiVo.
TiVo. No 360, though. I wonder if I can just walk up and turn it on. Nope! That must be really hard sometimes with the guy's best friend in the world and his wife not really liking each other. Like, the only reason they seem to tolerate each other is because, you know, they both love Alan. That's gotta be difficult being in the middle of that.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the Harry Gallet Show.
Thank you. Thank you, everybody. We have a great show tonight. I've been talking with the best-selling author, Alan Wake, about his new book, The Sudden Stop. Yeah, good read. Go buy it. No, it is a good read. Look, I'm going to be honest here.
Is that wise?
No, but I'm going to do it anyway. I got people who give me the lowdown on books. I'm a busy guy. but this one I actually read from cover to cover. I mean, I'm a big fan.
Wow, thanks.
Now, this might be a spoiler for those who haven't read the book yet, based on the sales figures, the two people out there who haven't read the book yet. But this last book is all about the death of the main character, the hard-boiled New York detective, Alex Casey. Now, there's been a lot of outrage about this. Why the hell did you kill Casey? What the hell were you thinking, man?
Good riddance. No, seriously, though. 7 years and 6 books is a long time. He was a gloomy guy to spend all your working hours with, and it was a good run. But it's time to explore new things. My next book will be a departure from the old for me.
You selfish bastard, always thinking of yourself. Well, you've certainly given us a lot of entertainment over the years. And now that you mention it, Casey was a gloomy guy. Never had much luck with his love life with the ladies. Was that autobiographical in any way?
Yeah, no kidding. Casey's lady friends tended to die on him. With Casey, it was all about his pain. No, nothing autobiographical about that. I'm a happily married man. My wife is my muse.
Aww. Well, congratulations. That's great to hear. So, how's the publicity tour been treating you?
Good. Great. But I gotta say, I'm glad to be back home in New York.
Boy, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately.
Something's cramping.
Parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Oh, man. Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Well, I did also write several books.
Well, your latest novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there who haven't bought it yet. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the evening. Alan Wake, Sam Lake. Once more, do the face for a Sam. And our musical guests, Poets of the Fall. Thank you. And
at least I'd been funny. I told myself I could live with that.
That was pretty good banter.
Did you watch the show?
I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know.
Okay, Grumpy. You want an aspirin or something?
Are you going to start with me about drinking now?
You know what?
I should have followed
Go
her advice.
Back to sleep, Alan.
But suddenly I was...
Oh.
What? Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence. Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal. Then you can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight. Just take a shower and go back to bed, huh?
Yeah. You're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. A vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet. Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin. I had to return to Cauldron Lake to save Alice. I'm going back to the lake to finish this. I'm going to write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms, to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
The last page is still in the typewriter. I need to read it first. Everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone. Barry, take her gun.
Are you kidding me?
Miss Weaver, close the door when I leave.
I don't remember this. Aw.
Good luck, Al.
See you later. When I got out, it was warm and sunny. I'd flicked the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake. On Zane's page, I'd stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed.
Why was the float truck there?
Alone, in daylight, surrounded by the beauty of the Pacific Northwest landscape, it was hard not to let doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk everything up to a dream, a delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. There would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set.
I gotta do this for everyone this darkness has consumed. For Rose and Stucky and that guy from the lodge. Ranger Rusty. Even Nightingale. So it seems the trick, the thing that will save the world, is Alan diving into Cauldron Lake and activating the clicker. That will allow him to get to the final page and literally end this. I guess without the ending, the story is just going into a holding pattern, giving the dark more and more time to wake up. Cauldron Lake Campgrounds, your home in the pines. Visit the Haunted Witch's Ladle. Senior country cabins are bear-free campsites. Enjoy the sunny lakeshore. I didn't realize until I saw bear-free that I'd seen this one before. Journey Owl gives it 3 stars and rates it good. Can't read that. Well, I have to look in the tunnel now. It gets blocked off down there. It's also dark in here, I suddenly realize. No comments in the peanut gallery, Alan? No? The truck had conveniently jackknifed across the entire road. There was no way I was getting through here. Not if I still hope to make it to Cauldron Lake. I was half expecting a truck to fall from the sky behind me as I exited the tunnel and seal it off forever. Hey, don't mind me, I'm just driving like an idiot while I look around for collectibles. Honestly, it's the end of the world. The posted limits and such are really more like suggestions. Oh, man. Am I really going to do this? Oh man, maybe they won't let me jump over. That would be great. That would be perfect. No! Oh no! It's because I can't see the edge over here, you see. I noted as he was leaving that Alan seemed to be carrying a regular-ass flashlight again. And honestly, I can't blame the guy, given that, you know, he was leaving the heavy-duty lantern with his friends. Although, they were in the well-lit room. I feel like they won't need it. They're in literally the safest place in the entire world right now. All right. Thank you. Let's hit that sign! Yeah! It's not. Watch for ice on bridges. Well, I don't see any. You see, kids, it's funny because it's September here and not, you know, winter. Oh, goddammit. Wait. Yeah, this is another one. Okay, that's weird. Let's not just leave this right in front of the bridge, then, since there's a fucking parking lot right, literally right here. I will, however, just leave it in the middle like a jackass. Where do I look? Where do I look? Oh, the Majestic! That was the one filled with roaches. Known for its cockroaches. Maybe we could save some money by... Where the hell is that? A crop symbol? No, it's not crop symbol, it's crop circle. Well, that's not a circle, but you know what I mean. That's the phrasing for it. Kind of looks like someone just drove a car around in there and just peeled out all night. Is that meant to be the Anderson farm? I don't think so. No, there isn't enough junk lying around in the fields. Press B to knock on the door and someone says, "Shouldn't you be saving the world, Alan?" Oh. Well, I guess not, because there's the timer. The Majestic Motel, just down the road, come on in. Comfortable beds, clean rooms, wireless internet, laundry facilities, cable TV, and kitchenette in every room. Just dial 555-8923. That's 555-8923. You know, I know this is only 12 years ago, but it still made me feel really weirdly nostalgic to think, oh yeah, they would have, that wireless internet would be an advertising point at a motel in 2010, huh? Well, I'm BurningDogFace, and I will see you on the next episode of Let's Play Alan Wake again! When we head back out to, Cauldron Lake. Try to save the world from the purest evil it has ever faced. Wish me luck, Burning Dog fans. And stay in the light.